back to Times 912. Earlier this week, we told you about oak wilt. It is something that can kill red oaks in just a matter of weeks.
The good news is apparently it's pretty easy to prevent the spread of this. Joining us via Zoom to help us do just that is Brian Schwingle. He is a Forest Health Program Coordinator in the DNR's Division of Forestry. Hi, Brian.
Hello, good morning.
I appreciate you being with us this morning. First of all, what is oak wilt? Let's start with what this is.
Oak wilt is a disease of our oak trees. It's caused by a microbe. All diseases are caused by microbes, and this microbe is a fungus. And the fungus is not native to this part of the world, and that's what causes oak wilt.
And the image that we're seeing here is a tree pre-oak wilt on the left, and then on the right, the tree that has it?
That's right. So this is a Dakota County red oak, and the image on the left shows the very initial symptoms of oak wilt. So the initial symptoms of oak wilt are the trees, the leaves at the outer edge of the canopy kind of turn drab green and then brown, and then they rapidly fall off the tree. So that progression photo there shows in a little over 2 months, that tree went from 100% leaved to losing like 90% of its leaves. And so when people see that on a red oak, it's a very good indicator that it's oak wilt.
If this has been around, I'm reading that it's been around since the 1940s. What is it about the, is there something happening with the current conditions that's like speeding up its severity, or what's going on there?
So oak wilt is a very unique invasive species. So it's non-native. It damages our forests, damages people's yard trees, and it's non-native. What's unique about oak wilt is that it is a slow mover, like you said. It was first discovered in Minnesota in the 1940s, and it's only spread to cover actually less than half of the state. That's, people cannot say that about almost any other invasive species. The reason why it's such a slow mover is it's because it's a very inefficient natural mover. The stars kind of have to align for oak wilt infection, above ground oak wilt infection to occur. You need the fungus to be sporulating. You can see the pictures right there of the spores. And you need these insects out and about that carry the spores from a diseased piece of wood or tree to a fresh wound. And you need the tree tissue itself to be susceptible. And that susceptibility period, the high risk period, is from April through July. And so one way to stop, prevent that infection is not to wound your oaks. And so I just saw your previous segments. You know, it's gardening season. I want to get out there. I want to go to the farmer's market for sure. I'm out in my yard working. And so I understand why people this time of year, it's starting to get nice. They want to go out there. They want to clean up their yard. They might want to prune their branches here or there. But we just ask people, please wait until after July. Because if you're able to, if we are all able to minimize human-caused wounds on oaks, we'll prevent all kinds of oak wilt all over the state. And so don't prune April through July. If you have to prune for whatever reason, sometimes people have to prune. Sometimes like homeowners insurance forces people to prune. If you're able to cover that wound with a tree wound paint or a latex paint in a couple minutes after pruning, and if that paint dries, that 100% prevents oak wilt too.
It prevents it, or it prevents it from getting there? So like if you cut a branch and then you paint the remaining part of the tree where that branch just came off, it will prevent the spores from being able to get in there, et cetera?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. It actually forms like a physical blockade so that the sap beetles that are flying around with the oak wilt spores on their backs, they can't, if they deposit those spores, the spores can't germinate and grow through the paint.
What is it about the red oak versus the white oak that why red oak just can't handle it as well?
So we have like three oak species that are considered red oaks. So they have the sharply pointed leaf margins, and then we have actually three species in the white oak group too. And they're genetically pretty distant relatives. They have anatomical differences in their tubes in the wood that carry up and down the water. And white oaks are able to kind of wall off the pathogen inside the wood much better than red oaks. So red oaks, the pathogen just spreads very quickly. At about 1 month after infection, that's when symptoms occur. And then from the point at which symptoms occur, the tree dies over 1 to 2 months. And again, the main symptom to look for is total leaf, total canopy discoloration and like 90% leaf drop in 1 to 2 months in the middle of summer. So June, July, August. If you are walking on a trail or if you see this on your driveway and you have a carpet of red oak leaves or even white oak or bur oak, that's a very good indicator of oak wilt. Now, I will say with the recent droughts that we have, the metro area has experienced 4 consecutive growing seasons of below normal precipitation. And some of those years, 2021, 2023, I think even 2022, were pretty severe droughts. We currently aren't in a drought, but really severe multiple droughts are super stressful to our trees. And we've seen a tremendous amount of oak death in the last couple of years across the entire state because of complications with drought. When we have really severe drought, oaks can die in a way that mimics oak wilt. And so particularly now, if you think you have oak wilt and you're going to invest in control, I highly recommend investing in a lab confirmation of the disease before you invest anything in control, because there are a lot of lookalikes. It's particularly important with bur oak and white oak to get a lab confirmation before investing in control or prevention.
Okay. So interesting, Brian. Thank you for your time this morning. We appreciate you being here with us.
Thanks for having me. Happy Arbor Day.
Yeah, happy Arbor Day. We will add links to more resources about oak wilt on our website at minnesotalive.com.